deep and angry inside, you're deep and angry outside right now.
I feel like the angriest dog in the world.
Oh, you're such a sweet, gentle dog.
No.
You mean so well.
No. You think I'm a dog like that kind of dog?
No, bigger.
Bigger.
Bigger, but cute like that.
You know what really gets me? The disparity between how I feel inside and what I see on the films.
What is that?
You know, I always used to think that I'm like a monster or some monstrous Caliban gook thing. And I go to the mirror and I just look like a human. I guess a lot of monstrous people look human, though. Might get some hint that there something's off, but how can I be so unhappy when all the films show me externally that everything is so nice? It looks nice. It's warm. It's nice. But I don't feel good.
Don't feel good now.
I rarely feel good, to be honest.
That's untrue. You're not being truthful. You feel good a lot of times. I think you gotta start telling yourself you feel good.
And then I have to wind up making movies about people who don't feel good. You know, it's like my friend Nina Menkes, who makes these films. They're all about oppression, right? But I guess she takes oppression to such a stylistic level of 45 minutes of a woman playing cards in a casino being oppressed. Okay, and it's in black and white, and it's an art movie. So it's a condition of oppression. It performs oppression in the film. Everything I do is so analytical. I can't live in the moment. I can't live in this life. I'd rather come back as the sun. Just burn for a billion years. I want to be the sun, the sea.
I think
a human is, I don't know what the human is. I'm inventing drama. Is that what you're saying?
When's the last time you felt happy?
Maybe when I was Roman's age.
You can't say that truthfully. What about us? About all the happiness we've shared.
Yeah. No, I don't.
What are you? You just gotta give yourself a chance to feel your happiness. Stop searching externally. It's already there. It's about acceptance, Mark. This is the happiness. And more will come.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at yourself. Look how beautiful and sexy and smart you are.
You think I'm responsible for you having to have a job?
Yeah.
Like, I could get you out of that job. What would you do without Vadim and Sergey and fat bitch, as you call that lady who I was who you wrote the brief for?
That's really good.
Then what happened?
And now they start living. Because there's no way to go back to their house.
They can't time travel back.
Uh-uh.
And how do they like their new life?
They do. They like it a lot.
What do they like about it?
Well, everything. They like the bears. They like to go swimming. And that's what I haven't read the whole book.
Okay, ready, take one. Pablito clavó un clavito con un palito. Con un palito, clavito, clavó un clavito. Dígala.
Savez-vous planter les choux? Savez-vous planter les choux? À la mode et à la mode, savez-vous planter les choux? À la mode de chez nous.
It's very interesting. It's like when I talk to Mama, God love her, she doesn't have any of these identity crises or problems. Not even an awareness. If she does, she doesn't talk about it.
What's her identity, her sense of herself?
She's French-Canadian Catholic, and that's period. I was an enigma to a lot of people. They didn't know what I was, so they most of them took me for Italian. Oh, you're an Italian. So I said, oh, you want me to be Italian? I'll be Italian. You're forever searching.
For what?
For something about who you're supposed to be. Well, my father being illiterate and not having read anything, but very, very bright, very, very articulate in his own way. But I never asked him the right questions. I discovered that after he died.
What were the questions you wanted to ask him?
What was it like growing up in the Dardanelles? What did his father really do, and what did he do, and why didn't he get some kind of a trade or whatever? What happened to the family from what I read about the great Sephardic heritage? And the word name Abu Lafia, where did it come from? Are you related anyway indirectly to all of these famous
rabbis and so forth. But he was so anti-Jewish that, and I think that was provoked either by the culture, because he adopted Greek. He spent all his time that I remember with the Greeks, playing pinochle with them and talking in Greek, taking me to Greek restaurants, and he spoke, ordered in Greek, and counted. When he had to count money, he would count in Greek. So we grew up, and I find, if I remember, being totally confused about my heritage. And about my name, how do you spell that name? What kind of name is Abelofia? How do you spell that crazy name? You're become almost victimized by the culture around you.
So who am I and why am I here?
What is, how do you spell your last name?
Lafia, L-A-F-I-A.
That's a very strange name.
Thank you.
Pedro, my gardener. Yeah, I'm. No matter how much I want to leave the job, no matter how much I want to find my true calling, I won't leave. It's not in me. And my marriage, my children, I love my family in so many ways, so many ways. Is it the right, am I in the right marriage? In a lot of ways I am, right? Although, there are fantasies I have that won't be fulfilled, probably. Am I going to run away and switch? And no, I'm not. I'm going to continue. I'm not going to change out of what I've jumped into. I don't know how to. I can't even give you an example of when I've switched off a course I've started of big things. Really, there's only three. My schooling, studying at Stanford, the electrical engineering, it's not right for me. Did I change? No. I had to see a psychiatrist. I panicked. It's the same pattern. Get to Intel for 12 years, 13 years. I panicked. I've done well on one hand, but I don't totally enjoy it. It's too hard for me. It's like an uphill battle. Am I going to change? Probably not. You know, we've talked about it. There have been like three periods when I've contemplated seriously, but without any action of change. Okay? And thirdly, my marriage. When I met you and fell in love with you, I knew, to me, it was so intuitive. That was actually the most intuitive. Just, it's the most intuitive thing of my life, was just falling in love with you. I think all my dreams and of who you were and who you could become were just so right for me. And you know, were those, have dreams match reality? In a lot of ways, yeah, and in some ways, no. Am I gonna change? Am I gonna get out of the marriage because of that? No. So my husband tries to tell me I have many options that I could get out of the marriage and he only wants the best for me. I'm not going to get out of the marriage. I'm not going to leave. Look at my brother. He won't leave. That's the kind of people we are. We don't change. No matter if it kills us. Look at him. He's just physically hurting. He's mentally hurting. I mean, I am to a lesser degree. I don't know. They're my parents. They don't change. Bought this house in Redwood City. Did they ever move up? Did they ever? No. They just stayed in it. That's it. We're creatures of habit, actually. It's amazing.
Not self-directed. I either am directed by the people around me. Then if I'm directed that way and unhappy, then it's irritating. But I'm not self-directed, so I'm not guiding myself somewhere. So, kind of what the luck of the draw. What chance brings. I'm deceiving myself. I think if I was filthy rich, I would not have these episodes. I wouldn't. I'd be more self-directed. Of course, I think I'm deceiving myself. I am filthy rich. I have this husband, this beast, beast. He's a beast. Such a beast. I see you, like, with your brother and the records, scratching the records. You get so into something. It's just like, you go so deep. You're like savage. All I want to do is eat. It brings me the most pleasure. Just food. Enslaved in Russia. I didn't think of that. My mom told me that. See? I don't have my own original thoughts.
Worse than I thought. They're really a mess. You're the kind of person that they just eventually give drugs to. You know, take some drugs.
Maybe that's good. What's wrong with that? Help. It's helpful. Look, it's helped your brother. It's helped Elliot. Helps Vanessa. They just need to rebalance. So, nothing wrong with it. Maybe. For a moment. A few moments. I don't know. I mean, I'm trying. I try to tell. I try. All this awareness, all this. Doesn't help me sleep. Does it help me? Like psychoanalysis. That's what I had in San Francisco. And I thought the man was excellent. It was helpful. But it was when we got married. Wasn't it? Doctor, I forgot his name. Jeff Goldberg referred me to him, and then I recommended him to Dr. Shervin. He never said much. I think then it was coming to terms in a way with, you know, or just you and I and our marriage and Mommy. Our differences.
Get Mommy.
Get you know, I had to reconcile Mommy. What your father said to me. I reconciled. He advised me really against marrying you.
You don't want to do this.
Your husband is an artist. You know the kind of life you'll lead? He is an artist. What he says, you're educated, come from a good family, you're going to have a hard time. Not going to be easy. He's an artist. He's selfish. He's going to do what he wants. Probably said you were a good man, loves you, but he knows who you are. He's father. He didn't necessarily shape you. He let you be who you are.
Look at Roman's been coloring. These are delicious.
I'm going to shirt.
Okay, so it's a good peak.
I'm eating all these.
Is there more?
Huh?
Are there more?
Is it
thank you, Roman. Thank you, darling. Thanks, honey. You're sweetie.
Thank you, Dedushka.
We have only limitation. We have one bed. And I have to carry one bed and support mom.
Come, Hobby. Just a second. Love you, Mark. Healed. Is that my own psychoanalysis? Look at you.
What?
Just excited. Excited. It's wonderful. You're just who you are. You don't hide it. That's it. You've always been honest. That's nice.
Everything is with my mother, everything is manipulated or molded to fit. Why? It's timed. It's the right time for everything. It's too fucking regimented. You see? Rules.
Just to let go. It's hard to let go. It's hard to try to control and plan.
Mommy,
not in my genes.
Mommy?
Oh.
The control and plan is in your genes.
Yes, not in my genes. It's in my shaping. That's what they shaped.
Right.
Where Mommy. Our shaping is suck juice.
Mommy.
Wise experience. I mean, she's lived very well, but she's suffered a lot, you know, physically, right. Mentally, you know, spiritually.
Yeah. I never have memory of pleasure, only tension, only concentration how to survive. In all small things, it's only fight to survive. But I couldn't avoid Hitler, I couldn't avoid anybody who reminded me his behavior. He just jumped on the country, and we were one of million people who were destroyed, almost destroyed. But maybe the wisdom of my mother, who took us in 1 week before we were destroyed, to move us to another part of Russia. And from that moment, I only remember struggle. I have to work when I was probably 6 years old, when we came to another part of Republic, it's called Uzbekistan. They gave us very small room. There is no place to sleep, all of us. So we sleep at daytime. We eat at the table. At nighttime, we sleep on the table. So this is the only place we could sleep. But we have to work. And only me who has to work. What I did, he got a lot of grapes. And he asked me to push these grapes to make wine. So for 8 hours a day, I jumped and pushing these grapes. He ate and I pushed to make them juicy. And he gave more. And I jumped all day long. I was so small, but I didn't go to school yet, and I made wine for him. So I learned that my existence were very important because of my work. We have this small room.
Okay.
Yeah. So then my mother decided that my sister was privileged. She needs more education, and I can get it later. My mother was the ruler of the house, and her rule were, we have to listen. There's no answer for no. There's no. Just follow what she said. If once I came, her rule was come home no later than 10 o'clock. If I came, then, because opera finished at 10 o'clock, and I didn't want to run before. And she never let me come because it was 10:20, because I ran from opera, tramway didn't come. I didn't have money for car. And I ran 10 or 15 blocks, and I was late. And she never let me come to home. As strict as she was. You should understand how strict my mother was. Yeah, so
It's a different, very different generation. You know, we never led easy life. You know, it was a lot of pressure on us, but we reach a lot of things in life just because we follow rules. It was goal. It has to finish this. Never stop. Goal. Only when I finished school, I came to medical college. Before I brought home papers that I got satisfaction from high school, I can bring home to show mom. No, I brought to college. And unfortunately, I met a woman who told me, let's go with me in the corner of this building. I went. She said, you're Jewish. We don't accept Jewish people to be a doctor. I said, wow. The time I find out that I'm Jewish, I didn't know that I'm Jewish. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I never thought about this too much.
She's not able to have an interior, say, comfort or acceptance of herself. All the external justification of meaningless makes her feel good for a second, but it doesn't help build up a feeling she already has. She just doesn't have that feeling inside herself. And so, in a way, translate that to me. I'm so hard on myself because I also can't, like, just accept some of the positive things about myself. She's not able to. She never has been. Doesn't know how. Her. You know, she grew up in a time when she was just very impoverished. And there wasn't even a thought about that. The thought was all about survival. And she totally translates that coming to this country and raising me. It's just about survival. There's pleasure, but it's very fleeting. And there's no long-lasting feeling about pleasure in herself. Good thing is, cooking there, talking to her, and Lola hears all that, and she says, well, I know myself, I love myself, I'm going to be different. Finally, a generational breakthrough. Lola, look at you.
We help her to satisfy this everything, you know, a new situation. We didn't have at the beginning much money too. So she wasn't spoiled girl. She didn't have extra shoes or extra dress, you know, very strict. I didn't have pleasure from you know, good clothes or good something, you know, presents, you know, no. Nobody celebrates much birthdays, you know, just pleasure bigger than this, not so small. She's a responsible person. And it's why it's hard, you know, to be responsible for so many things. Everybody will be hard, you know, if you have responsibility. You have to, the rules inside of her, she knows she has to do so many. That I am thinking why she's so...
From the children to you, you're like a big kid, Mark. You are another child to look after with these children. Why am I hard on myself? It only gets harder.
I'm
more complicated.
You're my child.
Everything, and then you own a home, and everything, all the bills, and then everyone's needs, you know, much less yourself. I try to think about my own needs, but that's even a hard look. My mom never thought about her own needs. Her pleasure was taking care of other people. So maybe I struggle with that, because in America, it's all about trying to think about yourself, but I'm not so good at that either. I'm not. When my father thinks about himself a lot, he very much, he's an expert at that, but my mom is not. My mom thinks about others first. She's very, both my parents are very responsible. They're very humble. Well, my mother is very humble, very modest, but very generous. I try to tell myself, everything is good, just stop worrying. These things come up. My project, I just get very, it's not easy for me, and I get nervous about it, and I want to do a good job, and I don't even totally understand it.
But if you're so hard on yourself, it's harder to do your project. Because you diminish opportunity to make decisions, because you become weak, you know? Instead of being stronger, you're so hard on yourself, you become weaker and bitter.
Yeah, I give up so much energy to...
Yeah.
I know that. Everything affects everything. I'm not pleasant to be around. Lola observes everything. I'm not calm, I'm not gentle, I'm abrupt. Everybody around me, and even myself, I don't rest. I don't know. It's a bad vicious circle. I'm not sure how to totally get out of it.
What do you think can help you?
I want it just to go away. I don't know what can help me. I have to just finish it. That's the only way. I don't know.
That's it. Very sad. What do you think? How to help her? What can you do to help? What Lola can do to help? What she can help? What we can do? What she can do? What is your thinking about?
All this tension, all this love. It's nice. Nice.
Is there anything your parents tell you that helps you, or that...
No. No. It just reaffirms how they are, right? One thing is, my dad got very emotional there. I don't know if you caught that. He really... was ready to cry. He teared. And I never see that. Not never, but it's rare. I think he really holds back his emotions. I don't know why he does that. He really controls them. Tries to. Where I just cry, he doesn't. I think he's probably wanted to cry a lot. He's had a tough battles. His career has aspirations.
Yeah, I'd like to see more of his, of those emotions and understand them. Or just see them. I don't know, understand. I think he's kept away a lot of his struggles. I don't know why. Why he's hit, I don't know, intentionally or not. I don't know which one it is. I think he, I don't know if he doesn't feel like he can, or he'll
He's never felt comfortable enough to do that, or he's embarrassed by them. I don't know, I'll have to ask him.
Coconut tree.
A follow B and B follow C.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. Bubbles, my.
Comparing myself to somebody else, or, you know, yeah, comparing, but not that it makes me ever feel better about me, instead of just focusing on me. It's like,
Mommy,
I don't know why
now,
I do that.
Mommy.
And I'm realizing it doesn't make me feel good, but that's
now,
actually
Mommy.
A pattern of my way. And I think I'm very needy of external, external justification or external approval. Somehow I don't approve myself.
Where did you study from me?
The daughter? Oh, that's her? Beautiful woman. That's her father, right? Brave woman. Very brave. Very driven. Very direct. Could have been me. Irina Putin? No. I have to tell you, I'm scared to go home.
Things I could be, and all the things that
now sing something
me.
Deep, okay?
My sadness overwhelmed me when I thought about all the things I could be.